young boy. What do you want for Christmas?
Well, Santa, I would like Paul Blart Mall Cop on Blu-ray.
Is he your favorite actor?
Yeah, Kevin James is a very good actor.
Yeah, that's good.
All right.
Come here, young sir.
Hello, Santa.
How you doing?
Great, how are you?
I'm good.
So for Christmas, I would love a party pail of rainbow sherbet. You can buy them at Kroger for about $3.
Have you been a good boy?
I like to think so, yes.
Have you been doing your chores?
Occasionally.
Okay.
Thank you, Bobby.
How you doing?
Hi, Santa. You know what I want for Christmas, Santa?
What do you want?
I want another episode of Chieftain Live.
Ho, hold on to your seats for this one, folks.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cooling, all shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel-Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said, "I might as well kick it." First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of a champagne glass. Is this what the people of Bel-Air?
Hello, everybody. I'm your host, Julian Hermes, and welcome to another exciting episode of Chieftain Live. In this episode, we'll get some Christmas fun facts from students, take a look at foreign Christmas traditions, and I sit down with Mark Woods for an exclusive Q&A about the spring play. But before we get into that fun and informative content, let's look at our top stories featured in today's Chieftain. Our raffle was restructured this year with the implementation of the band draft. The competition ramped up students to sell more and more tickets, and it was a dramatic and exciting raffle season. Jake Ream brings us a recap on this year's raffle and takes a special look at team leadership and team alumni. Brother Rice's winter sports season is upon us, and this year we're expecting them to be better than ever. Two teams, bowling and skiing, are looking forward to a very successful winter year. Jonah Vinos gives you all a special look on these teams and what their expectations are for the season. And finally, the Christmas season is upon us, and people are setting up the decorations and Christmas trees with their families. However, have you ever thought about what kind of decorations are the best? Sam Lumen and Tommy Schaefer go at each other in this debate on whether real Christmas trees or fake Christmas trees are the best. Make sure you check out these stories and more today in the Chieftain app. Now let's get it started. As you all know, we have many foreign exchange students at Brother Rice. We want to take a new look at these students to see how they celebrate the holidays and ask them what their Christmas traditions were. Let's head into Michael Murphy, who's bringing you all an expose on our fellow students in the Wyoming group. Here's to a very Wyoming Christmas.
We have many foreign exchange students who've become the fabric for our community. We decided to take a deeper look into the holiday traditions of two of our students.
Billy. So during Christmas, since China is, they used to be a communism country, they don't really practice religious, but it's not a Christmas now used to be a big thing, but now it's kind of huge things, but it's like commercialized. So supermarket or shopping mall. They're gonna have a huge sale, and they still sell like those decoration for Christmas in the mall too.
The Christmas feeling was kind of stronger than Drake City. Those restaurants provide with some Christmas, you know, meals. It's a little bit different from the common menu, so. We don't do really much to celebrate Christmas, but Christmas is a good time to go shopping and...
With Christmas coming right around the corner, everyone's jamming to who Mr. Higdon believes made the best Christmas album of all time, Michael Bublé, and decorating their Christmas trees with their families. In the spirit of Christmas, Bobby Coons went out into the Brother Rice hallways to give us a very jolly edition of Christmas fun facts.
All right, Charlie. So you know the great debate as Christmas is coming up, real tree versus
yes,
fake tree.
Yes, it is Christmas time.
So what do you prefer, real or fake tree?
I definitely prefer a real tree, only because of one reason. I'd say the needles on the real tree are a lot more spiky than those of the fake tree. Thank you.
So we're here with Fun Facts and James. What would you like for Christmas?
To not get ripped on anymore,
Do you think it will happen?
Yeah, there's no chance.
You're an easy target, aren't you?
Yeah.
All right, Jackson, what's the best stocking gifts for Christmas?
I'd say the best stocking stuffer I've ever received is probably a Phillips head screwdriver or a 28-ounce T-bone steak.
All right, McGeester, so Christmas is coming up, and what is your favorite holiday tradition?
Bobby, I'm sorry, we're not friends.
Now, for our next segment on Chieftain Live, let's... Did you hear that? Is that coming through the audio? Is that Santa Luge?
Better way to kick off this Christmas season without yours truly, Santa Luge. Here, Santa Luge is going to the cafeteria and getting some cookies for his nighttime adventure. And Santa can't be complete without a tall glass of milk. After buying these treats, Santa went to his colleagues and asked them important questions about Christmas.
So what are you asking for Christmas?
Mints.
Why mints?
You stay fresh.
Hey!
So which candy cane is your favorite flavor?
Mint.
Reindeer is your favorite?
Dasher.
Why?
He's fast. I like him a lot.
I'll give him that.
Christmas can't be complete without a couple gifts from Santa.
Ho ho ho! Merry Christmas!
What?
What's up, man? How you doing? You need a good kid?
Yeah.
Alright, make sure.
I'm not.
This weighs 2 pounds.
I had a great time here, Brother Rice. I'll see you folks next year. Merry Christmas. Ho ho ho!
After successful fall production, the Marion Rice Players are back at it with their spring musical. To find out more about it, I'd like to give a warm welcome to senior Mark Woods. Mark, thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me, Julian.
So, what is a spring musical?
It's going to be Little Mermaid this year. So, yeah.
When are the auditions for that?
I'm not sure exactly. It'll be sometime like early January after winter break. They don't have a specific time out yet, but that's going to be figured out pretty soon and will be broadcast around.
So talk about the audition process. How like stringent is it?
So for the musical, it's a lot more difficult. Usually what we do for the musical is we'll have workshops before, dancing, like kind of just getting into character stuff. Just like making sure that you know exactly kind of what you're doing before you get in the actual audition room. So once we show up there are different time slots, and they're usually about like 20 people per slot. So we'll have like people doing specific reads for specific characters, stuff like that, and then at the same time like kind of dancing stuff or like singing workshops and stuff, kind of just to like figure out what kind of you're doing best at, and then kind of go for there for normal auditions.
Okay. So I was also told that there's a shortage of guys.
There is.
So where could some guys fill in?
We need a lot of guys for background stuff, especially for this show. There's a lot of just like background guy characters. Honestly, if you're a guy out there, go for whatever you think you might be able to do well at. You know, if you might have a hidden talent of singing or something, just kind of go out there and see what you can do. We definitely need a lot of like backup guys, but we need sound crew, stage crew. We need guys for that. So honestly, just any guys that want to come out, we need you. So,
okay. So how much of a commitment is on Ricky?
It's really not that crazy, especially even if you're doing like a sport in the spring. It's usually pretty good around like working around your schedule, making sure that we have time for you to do what you need to do, but also time to commit and make the show as good as it possibly can. We get a lot of people who do like sports and stuff who still do RP.
So.
All
right, awesome. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for coming on the show.
No problem. Thank you for having me.
All right. Well, that's it for this episode of Chieftain Live. Make sure you check out this month's edition of the Chieftain and Chieftain app. I'm Julian Hermes, and remember, don't sit on Mr. King's lap, he's not Santa. Happy holidays, everybody.